This is a production study created by Autodesk to compare common civil and infrastructure workflows when completed in Civil 3D versus being completed in base AutoCAD. In this session, we are looking at piping and drainage design. This workflow includes the following tasks: surface analysis for falls and catchment areas, network layout, horizontal and vertical, crossing pipes clash check, drainage profile, drawing production plans and profiles, manhole schedule, automation of labeling. It is important to understand drainage patterns across a project surface prior to the design. In AutoCAD, this is done by creating a polyline trail from the lowest contour line to a point perpendicular to the next highest contour line and continuing to the next highest from there. This pattern continues until there are no more contours that have a perpendicular point to attach to. Civil 3D has the water drop tool to place a point on the high end of the surface. The water drop then creates a polyline downhill to where the surface no longer allows flow. The water drop tool is more accurate because it looks at surface triangles rather than the contour lines, which may be spread out enough to miss details of the surface. You can also place many more water drop points more quickly than what the AutoCAD process could accomplish. When designing a pipe network, it will need to be laid out in both the horizontal and vertical. In AutoCAD, this means drawing the run of pipes, placing vertical points where the direction changes in bearing or elevation. Blocks will be placed to represent manhole and inlet structures at these vertex points. The segments of the pipe run will then be used in the profile view to indicate where the vertical design will be created. The profile view can be copied from the profile design of the existing surface. Manhole and inlet rim elevation locations are interpolated from the surface triangles and placed in the profile view. Pipe depth and slope can be aided by offsetting the proposed profile down to minimum depth in the profile view. The top of the pipes can be drafted from structure to structure, staying below this minimum depth profile. Then the pipe top can be offset down to reflect the pipe width. The lines marking the location of the structure should be offset to either side to show the structure width. A line representing the rim and the bottom of the structure will finish this design in profile view. In Civil 3D, you will identify which pipe network structure parts and pipe parts should be used. The structures are placed in plan view and the pipes will connect these structures automatically. While designing the plan view, the pipe and structure depths are also placed. The pipe network will be displayed in the profile view so that we can check the depths and slopes. Checking where pipes may clash with other pipes or other objects is important to ensure constructability. In AutoCAD, you can copy an already created cross-section view with existing conditions and proposed conditions in the view. The location of crossing pipes in plan view identifies where the pipe will display in the cross-section view. Draw in the top of the pipe, then offset down by the width of the pipe to find the bottom. Draw pipe end lines and trim to clean up the pipe location. The pipe will be drafted as an ellipse to indicate the pipe width and profile view vertical exaggeration. A drainage profile reflects the alignment over the pipes and structures and may deviate from the alignment of the road design. While the profiles would be generally close, having a precise location and depth information where the two alignments differ is important to the construction of the pipe network. It also helps identify where issues may appear along the pipe design that the road profile would miss. In AutoCAD, you can start by copying a profile grid from one of the other profiles that you've created. Make sure no objects come along with that grid. You will need to create an alignment over the pipe network centerline, which may diverge from the road centerline. You will need to make existing and proposed profiles along the alignment over the pipe network. In Civil 3D, you will use the Create Alignment from Network tool, selecting the first upstream structure and then the last downstream structure. During the profile creation process, you can choose to add the existing and proposed surface profiles into the profile view. Due to sheet size and scale of the production sheets, you may be limited to how much space is available for plan and profile views along a pipe network. Navigate the plan view viewport over the alignment and rotate the view to best display the plan. You will do this for each of the sheets that is needed to cover the length of the pipe network in the project. You can then create profile views that you limit the length of to match how much of the alignment is in each sheet's viewport. In each sheet, navigate the profile view viewport over the appropriate profile view. You will likely need to clean up the profile views for each sheet. In Civil 3D, you would first use the Create View Frames tool. This identifies the station length available for each sheet. Then you would use the Create Sheets from View Frames, and the plan and profile viewports will be created in each sheet. Some cleanup may be necessary in each profile view to make sure the network depths are displayed appropriately. A manhole schedule captures the data about the manhole structures along a piping network. In AutoCAD, this can be done in a table that is manually created and populated with data. If the manholes are represented by blocks, especially blocks with attributes, this schedule can be automated somewhat. We can use the data extraction tools to find all the structures and export the data into a table. In Civil 3D, we can create these schedule tables by using the Add Tables and select a structure table. This will also find all the structures in the network and build the table for us. The Civil 3D tables are capable of displaying much more pertinent data from the network. You may need to make adjustments to the table style, but you have many options for display. Label automation helps keep pipe and structure data up to date when inevitable revisions occur. In AutoCAD, you can use multi-line text and type the needed information manually, or you could use fields attached to objects so attribute data can be added to the labels. This would allow some level of dynamic label updating when needed. In Civil 3D objects, labels are always dynamic to the object. While some static text can be included in the labels, many of the pipe and structure objects' properties can be added to the labels. In this situation, the labels were placed automatically but need to be repositioned to make them more readable. Depending on the density of your project, this process could take longer than actually creating the labels themselves. This has been a look at comparative workflows between Civil 3D and Base AutoCAD for pipe and drainage design.